Okay, so let's try to find out, did you all understand the utility of finding the field? Once you know the field, the force at a particular location, the magnitude of the force at a particular location will be straightforward. You just have to multiply mass with that field to get the force. Okay. Fine, let's try to do the further calculations now. Suppose you have, okay, it will be mathematically little bit involved, so okay, let's do the simpler one first. You have a ring. Okay, you have a ring. Let's first take this type of ring, which is in the plane of your screen, this ring. All right. Can you tell me what is the field at the center of this ring? Total mass is M and radius is R. What is the field at the center? See here. You can draw lines like this. Now you can see that the field because of this point mass, which is located over here, will be in which direction? This direction, right? Due to this point mass, the field will be in this direction. These two fields will cancel out each other. Similarly, anywhere you'll see, if you try to find the field, there will be a point diametrically opposite point will be there for which the field will be equal and opposite. So all these fields will cancel out and total field will come out to be zero. Getting it? So due to symmetry, clear? So if you place a mass at the center of the ring, it will not experience any gravitational force because field is zero. So mass into field, which is force, that is also zero. Clear, all of you? Okay, now try to find out the field because of the sector of the circle. Okay, let's say you have, this is a center, let's say radius is R and this angle is theta. Okay, mass is M. Total mass is M. It's a ring, sector of a circle. Sector of a circle, what does it mean? Oh no, sector of a circle means part of disk. So it's an arc, okay? It's a circular arc which makes angle theta at the center. Find out. Okay, Niranjan has got some answer. Others? Niranjan, that is dimensionally incorrect. Okay, let's see how we can do this. First, make full use of symmetry, okay? Divide it into two equal parts and then take this small mass over here and take another small mass symmetrically located over there. Okay, you'll see that the field because of these two will be in this direction. Okay, so these two point masses will have field along these two point masses direction. Okay, let's say this is dm, this is also dm. All right, I am taking this as phi. Okay, so this is also phi. I am taking symmetrically located dms, right? Let's see whether your answer is correct. These are the two fields, so you can see that horizontal component of these two fields get cancelled out. Okay, only vertical component remains. Integration is a scalar addition. You can't have a vector addition when you integrate. Okay, so that is why you can integrate only components along vertical and along horizontal direction in this case. Okay, so the horizontal component of the field get cancelled out and every point mass you consider over here, you'll have a symmetrically located point mass at the other part of the ring. Other part of the let's say arc. So your field will get cancelled out horizontally every time. Okay. So you'll have only net field along y direction. Okay. So that will be E times cos of phi. All right. So let's say I'm considering small field due to the small mass dm. Okay. So if I take two masses at a time, the total field dey will be 2 times de cos phi. So de cos phi because of this and de cos phi because of that. Okay. De is what? G times mass is dm divided by radius square. That into cos of phi. Now the problem is that now you have two variables m and phi. So I need to write down mass in terms of phi. Okay. So if you zoom it a bit, you'll see that this dm will occupy the small length of the arc because mass is distributed on the arc, right? So if you consider a small mass, it will occupy small length also. So let's say this length is dl. Okay. So dm will be equal to mass per unit length, which is m divided by the arc length is what? R into theta, right? So this into dl is dm. Okay. And from the definition of angle, dl should be equal to r into d theta. All of you understanding, right? Is there any doubt? So dm is, why you are retracting the messages one by one? It's okay to be wrong. So m by theta into d theta. Actually, it is d phi, m by theta into d phi. Okay. Because I'm taking phi as a variable. Okay. So this will be equal to 2g dm, which is be equal to m divided by theta, that into r square, the cos of phi d phi. Okay. So total field will be integral of this. Are you able to see the screen? No. Able to see now. Now tell me the limits of integral. From where to where should I integrate? What should be the limits of integral? 0 to theta by 2 you have to integrate. Okay. Because when you say 2 times, every time you're considering one mass here, one mass there. Okay. So if you go from here to here, you're automatically considering corresponding masses from here to here. You're taking two masses at a time. Okay. So you'll integrate from 0 to theta by 2. But if you don't do two times, then you can integrate from minus theta by 2 to plus theta by 2. Okay. Because when you take 2, multiply with 2, you're saying that I'm taking two masses at a time. So the gravitational field will be integral of cos phi will be sine phi. Okay. So gravitational field will become equal to 2 times gm divided by r square theta into sine of theta by 2, right? So if I keep a mass m over here, if I keep a mass small m over here, the force experienced by the small m will be m into e. Okay. Once you know the field. Any doubts, anything you want to discuss, quickly tell me. This field is along J direction, right? So it will be J cap. See, even if you're understanding 60%, that is good enough right now to start with. So nobody will understand everything right from scratch if you're listening this for the first time. So all you have to do is after the class, sit with whatever we have done today, and you will be able to understand everything. You did not understand how we took the limit of integration. Dekho, this DM you have to take here, then here, then here, everywhere you have to take DMs, then only you have to cover entire arc, right? So that is why you need to go from this point to that point along this line to cover the entire mass. Okay, now what you're doing is when you're considering mass over here, you're considering another mass over there as well. So by the time you travel from here to there, you have already covered automatically all these masses. Okay, so the limits will be whatever angle this point mass over here makes to whatever angle this point mass makes from the vertical. Total angle is theta. This angle is theta by 2. This angle with the vertical, because this vertical line divides it into equal parts. So this will be theta by 2. So DM starts from 0, it goes to theta by 2. Sorry, theta, the angle phi starts from 0 and goes to theta by 2. Okay, clear now? You have a ring, okay, you have a ring. This ring, half of it is inside your screen and half of it is coming out of your screen. Okay, so basically the plane of the ring is perpendicular to your screen. Okay, this distance is Z from this point to the center of the ring. The distance is Z. Okay, the radius of the ring is R, mass is M. Okay, you need to find field at this point because of the ring. Point is along the axis of the ring. The point is along the axis of the ring. Okay, the ring is perpendicular to the plane of your screen. Okay, all of you tried. Should I do it? I'll do it now. All right, so let us do this now. So the field because of this, let's say DM, will be along this line, right? This field is, let us say, DE. Okay, this angle is theta, let's say. Okay, now can I say that angle theta will be same for whatever mass you take along the ring? Along the ring, whichever point you go, angle theta will be same. Is this correct statement? Okay. And is it also correct that the component, let's say DE's component along this axis, along the y axis, will be DE sine theta? This one will be DE cos theta. Now, if you join this one, okay, that ones will also have a same magnitude of electric field, the gravitational field. So it will have a vertical component downward. So the only component that remains will be along the axis. Is that also correct? The only component DE should be equal to DE cos theta, because sine theta component gets cancelled anyways. So when you sum it up, only component which is along the axis will remain. Is this statement correct? Okay, so DE is what? DE is G times DM divided by this distance square from here till this point. Okay, that is Z square plus R square. Okay, this into cos of theta. Now cos of theta can be written as Z divided by R square plus Z square raised to power half. Till now you're comfortable? Till now whatever we have done, you're okay? Okay, now you'll see that wherever you go, wherever this DM goes along the ring, Z is constant, R is constant, G is anyway constant. So all this expression comes out of integral. This thing is equal to GZ to Z square plus R square raised to power 3 by 2. Okay, integral of DM. And integral of DM is total mass only. Okay, so 0 to capital M, total mass. Fine, so this will be equal to G times M Z divided by R square plus Z square raised to power 3 by 2. Okay, and it will be along the axis. Towards the center. What happened to cos theta? Dekho. Drop a perpendicular from here. Okay, this will become right angle triangle. This one. Okay. So cos of theta in this right angle triangle will be what? Z divided by hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is this, which is using Pythagoras theorem, you'll get as Z square plus R square raised to power half. All of you understood how we get the gravitational field because of the ring. Now, if you place a point mass at that point, let's say M you place over there, the force will be M into field, because field is force per unit mass. Okay.